she's called back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless love. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I broke. Oh, 'cause I need you to see you. There goes my head shaking, and you are the reason my heart keeps bleeding. I need you now. And if I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure
everybody rise, please.
On every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. 'Cause I need you to see that you are the reason.
Who is giving this woman's hand to the hand of this man?
Her mother and I.
Please be seated. I want to thank all of y'all, the guests, for your attendance on this joyous occasion. Let me put my glasses on to make sure I get it all. I'm Kip Murray. My role as an ordained minister is to assist in these wedding vows. We've gathered here today to celebrate the union of Zachary Taylor and Elizabeth Ann Sidler. That's Lizzie for most of you. The gift of marriage is miraculous, and this ceremony presents us with a wonderful opportunity to celebrate the love shared between these two souls. Now, I'm going to start the love story, so y'all just get comfortable. It was May 18th, 2017. Both Lizzie and Zach worked at Topgolf. Zach worked the morning shift, and Lizzie worked the night shift. Lizzie introduced herself, saying that she was taking over his section. When he introduced her to his customers, he forgot her name. And she made him promise that he would never forget her name again, and he hasn't. Zach told Josh, his friend from grade school, that he thought Lizzie was cute, and Josh gave Lizzie Zach's phone number. Lizzie and Zach were texting and talking every day, but there was no invitation to go out. Lizzie was impatient. Finally, she asked, when he was going to ask her on a date. Zach explained he was waiting for payday so he could take her to a nice restaurant. Lizzie only cared about spending time with Zach and suggested they go to Steak and Shake. Their first date lasted for hours, so long that the manager was wondering if they were going to pay their bill. They talked even longer in Zach's truck. Lizzie wanted a kiss. He wasn't getting the hint. He wanted it to be special. Finally, Zach kissed her. Now, Lizzie put in parentheses when we were talking about this story. She said, "Sorry, Kip, but it was a great kiss. He's just so cute." After only 6 weeks, Zach asked Lizzie to be his girlfriend, and they were already talking about marriage. Lizzie wanted to graduate from paramedic school before marrying. She had no idea she was going to have to do paramedic school twice and then fight a pandemic. In July 2020, they bought their first house together. That winter, everything froze, including their toilets and all of their pipes. Lizzie's favorite memory during that time was repairing frozen pipes. Hats girls are problem solvers. They made suits out of trash bags and climbed under the house in freezing temperatures, wallowing in the frozen mud. Lizzie recalls, "We had no experience in plumbing, but we did it under our house. It made me love and appreciate Zach ever more, even more." Zach and Lizzie and her parents went to Cancun April 4th, 2021 to celebrate her graduation. She had bugged Zach wanting to know when he was going to propose, and he told her he wouldn't do it how or when she wanted. He wanted to surprise her. Little did she know that Zach, Don, and Cheryl had already made a plan. There'd be pictures, a sunset, photos on the beach that first night. However, on the long flight, lack of sleep, and nervousness, it had left Zach with a sour stomach and very nauseous. How are you feeling right now? Lizzie wanted to postpone the pictures for another night. Her parents insisted, and Lizzie was angry, thinking they were insensitive to Zach's illness. Actually, it was Zach whose mind was set on proposing that night on April the 4th, 2021. After many beautiful photos, Lizzie noticed her mom was still snapping pictures, so she turned away from Zach and made a goofy face at the camera. At that point, Cheryl said, "Lizzie, turn around." She said, "Is this really happening?" And there was Zach on one knee holding a ring for her to accept. Zach looked into Lizzie's eyes, saying, "Lizzie, I love you so much. You make me so happy. Will you marry me?" He held back tears so intensely that he almost looked angry. Lizzie said, "Absolutely, yes. And here we are tonight." Let us pray. Lord, please bless Lizzie and Zach tonight. Please put your hand on them and hold them through all their years. Please hold up their marriage to be a window through which your light shines. Amen. Okay, here we go. Zachary Taylor, do you take Elizabeth Ann Sidler? Let me restart that. Repeat after me.
Repeat after you.
I, Zachary Taylor, take you, Elizabeth Ann Sidler.
I, Zachary Taylor, take you, Elizabeth Ann Sidler.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
And my love for this day forward.
I take you as you are.
I take you as you are.
Loving who you are now.
It's good. It's good.
You don't look angry. That's good.
Loving who you are now.
And who you are yet to become.
And who you are yet to become.
I celebrate your triumphs.
I celebrate your triumphs.
And I mourn your losses.
And I mourn your losses.
You're getting me started.
I know.
as though they were my own.
As though they were my own.
I will love you and have faith in your love for me.
I will love you and have faith in your love for me.
Through all our years.
Through all our years.
And all that life may bring us.
And all that life may bring us.
Lizzie, please repeat after me. I, Elizabeth Ann. Take you, Zachary. To be my lawfully wedded husband.
Be my lawfully wedded husband.
My constant friend.
My constant friend.
My faithful partner.
My faithful partner.
And my love from this day forward.
And my love for this day forward.
I take you as you are.
I take you as you are.
Loving who you are now.
Loving who you are now.
And who you are yet to become.
And who you are yet to become.
I will celebrate your triumphs.
I will celebrate your triumphs.
And mourn your losses.
And mourn your losses.
As though they were my own.
As though they were my own.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And have faith in your love for me.
And will have faith in your love for me.
Through all our years.
Through all our years.
And all that life may bring us.
And all that life may bring us.
This is the only element I have learned in preparing for this ceremony. This is the only element that must legally occur. And it has to be done very clearly. And when I ask you, you must answer, I do. Not let me think about it. All right. Do you, Zachary Taylor, take Elizabeth Ann Sidler to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Elizabeth Ann Sidler, do you take Zachary Taylor to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
Okay. Rings on in the ceremony for marriage not only reflect the couple's desire to be faithful to one another, but the circular shape of the ring evokes the couple's unending commitment. These rings are important to the couple, a constant reminder of their partner's presence in the world. Zach. Okay. Repeat after me. Lizzie.
Oh, yep, that hand.
Lizzie.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor and love you.
I honor and love you.
Okay, Lizzie, repeat after me. Zach.
Zach.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor and love you.
I honor and love you.
By the power vested in me by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Zach, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, let me be the first to present Mr. and Mrs. Taylor.